Hi, I'm Andrew Hanna, and welcome to the Wine of the Week. Today I have the pleasure of introducing you to one of the world's greatest white wines. Grown in a historic vineyard in northeastern France, it began its life in a cellar converted from a 15th century fortress. It's made by one of the world's most respected and recognized winemakers, and was grown in a vintage heralded by critics as one of the best in recent memory. This is a wine that you can enjoy today or lay down and enjoy for a decade or more. So let's take a few minutes and check it out. Okay, so here we go. We're back with a glass of the 2009 Chanson Chassaigne Montrachet Blanc. Now off the top, I want you to know that there were only 416 cases of this wine produced in total. So we had to fight and scratch and claw just to get our hands on 120 bottles of this wine for the entire Ontario market. You know, so suffice to say, if you're interested in getting your hands on a few bottles of this, I'd encourage you to act quickly. It's sure to disappear fast. So, white Burgundy, you know, in my opinion, it's the greatest expression of the Chardonnay grape going. That said, in recent years, we've seen a movement away from Chardonnay, towards other white varietals. In my opinion, that's largely due to the fact that a lot of the hotter climate regions around the world have been producing a style of Chardonnay which is over-oaked and over-ripened and over-extracted, and the result is a style of Chardonnay that's just not that pleasant to drink. When we get back to Burgundy, we see what Chardonnay is all about. First off, the cool climate helps this wine retain a sense of freshness. The winemakers in this part of the world lean less on the use of new oak in the production of their wines. And again, oak is a complexity. It's a small addition to the wine, not the dominant feature. So when we look at Chanson, one of the key things to know here is that the winery is home to one of the most respected and well-known winemakers in the world, an absolute master with the Pinot Noir and Chardonnay grapes, a fellow named Jean-Pierre Confirant. And Jean-Pierre's fingerprints are all over this wine. What we see here is a sense of finesse and delicacy, an effort to extract, a sense of minerality and terroir from the sites where these grapes were grown. Jean-Pierre, is an absolute master when it comes to producing wines that are truly artisanal and that speak to the vintage from which they were harvested and the place they were grown. Now, the 2009 vintage across the board has been heralded by critics around the world as one of the greatest in recent memory for the production of fine whites from Burgundy. This is a wine that, while it's delicious and enjoyable today, certainly has the potential to improve for at least a decade or more. So if you're either just starting out a new cellar or if you're a collector of Burgundies, this is a great addition, something to buy and lay down for a few years. Now let's give the wine a try and see what we can find out. Yeah, see on the nose, there's a wonderful core of citrus fruit here. So I'm picking up things like grapefruit and orange and lime. There's a perfumed floral note here as well. I'm picking up just a touch of vanilla, which tells me that this wine was aged in oak barrels. Now let's give it a taste. So again, I'm picking up a lot of the same flavors that I was noticing on the nose. A freshness from the citrus fruit is definitely evident here. I'm also picking up some textural qualities that, speak to the fact that this wine underwent a process known as batonnage, or a stirring of the lees while the wine is in barrel. And again, this helps with the integration of the acids and preserves a sense of freshness in this wine, which I think is absolutely crucial with great Chardonnay. So, when I start to look at food pairings for this wine, again, Chardonnay is one of these wines that has the ability to pair with a wide range of different foods. So different white meats, different preparations of chicken and pork are great here. Lobster and crab would be a natural. Whitefish, again, a wonderful pairing. With fine wines, I keep finding myself coming back to cheeses as a benchmark for food pairings as well. So here, I think this wine definitely has the intensity and viscosity to stand up to fuller flavored cheeses. Things like Munster or Epoisse would be a wonderful choice for this wine. So there you have it, the 2009 Chanson Chassaigne Montrachet Blanc. It's $62.95 a bottle, We've got 26 packs of this wine available for the Ontario market. If you're interested in getting your hands on a few bottles, I'd encourage you to act quickly. Give me a call. I promise we'll do our best to get you fixed up with what you need. Until next week, I'm Andrew Hanna. Cheers.